On behalf of Bentley University, I welcome you to Convocation 2021. I call Reverend Dr. Robin Olson and the Spiritual Life team to lead the invocation. Please rise, and if able, remove your caps for the invocation.
Good afternoon. I am joined by two of my colleagues in the Spiritual Life Center, Rabbi Jeff Faust and Father Ted Brown. And we stand with you honoring all of the emotions of this moment. The scary, bittersweet, and yet especially oh so happy moments of this day. We stand for you, honoring the variety of religious, spiritual, and ethical traditions represented here in this arena. And I share a wisdom to begin from Sufi Muslim poet Jalaluddin Rumi, who wrote in the 13th century, and yet it sounds like he wrote it for us today, especially our brand new falcons. He said, "You were born with potential. You were born with goodness and trust. You were born with ideals and dreams. You were born with greatness. You were born with wings. You are not meant for crawling, so don't. You have wings. Learn to use them and fly." Falcon families, we are perched right now, one wing in the nest and one wing flying at Bentley. Will you join me in prayer as we pause to get ready for this momentous flight? And we will pause at the end of the invocation for you to observe in accord with your own custom or tradition. Will you pray with me? Gracious God, in whose names, many names we gather, we invoke your blessing upon our newest falcons. Be present with them as they stand this day on the threshold of so many Bentley beginnings. Grace them with gratitude for all of the people who have loved them and believed in them and helped them to come to this day. Bless our students with calm assurance as they bravely take flight into the welcome of a new community. And may you inspire the quest for the common good to be their passion and privilege. Guiding wisdom, we pray for our new leader, President Kreit, as he too begins his first day of school at Bentley. We call your blessings upon all the faculty, staff, and administration of Bentley University. May we lead by example, inspire by compassion, and teach by wisdom. And Divine Heart, we invoke your blessings upon the parents and extended families and friends of the class of 2025. It is so hard to say goodbye, even when dreams are coming true. And so we thank you for their love, sacrifice, and trust. With gratitude for the paths we have traveled and for joy for all of the journeys yet to be flown, we pause in silent reflection. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Olson, Father Brown, and Rabbi Faust. Please be seated. I now invite Andrew Shepherdson, Vice President for Student Affairs and Dean of Students, to the lectern.
Welcome to Bentley University. It is so good to see you here in person and have the opportunity to share with you this very exciting day. This is a week you will long remember. Yes, because it's the first day of college life, but also because it's a major return to normalcy. While I could, yes. While I can still recall the excitement and the anxiety that marked my own first few days as a college student, it does not compare to what you must be feeling after all you have been through. I was ready to explore the world on my own, discover new experiences, and develop new friendships. But I was nervous about leaving home and getting to know a new community. It's a time of mixed emotions, but I know that each of you are ready to succeed. That's why we've been looking so forward to you joining our community. We gather together for our convocation to help guide you. This formal academic ceremony is designed to help all of us reflect on the journey that lies ahead for the members of the class of 2025. Your university education at Bentley is designed to challenge you and make you think about the world differently than you have before. You will learn creative ways to approach problems, develop new knowledge, and to come to better understand your own limits. Our expectations are high, but we know you're ready for this challenge. You're joining a community of scholars. To help you get started, Bentley's provost and one of our dedicated professors will both share details about our esteemed faculty and insights in the role you will play in your own learning. One of your talent peers will perform, and your student government president will share her insights on the student experience. Most importantly, you will hear from the president of the university, who starts his Bentley journey with you, the class of 2025. I hope by the end of this ceremony, you will come away with three key understandings. Number one, over the course of your studies at Bentley, you will have the chance to find and develop mentors. These mentors can be faculty, they can be staff, and they can even be your fellow students. There are countless members of this community who are ready and willing to help you succeed. Number two, the next 4 years will be filled with opportunities, but only if you step forward to do so. If you have not yet, look to our Bentley Plus program to help you make the most of your time here. Number three, know that you are an important member of an amazing group of individuals that together forms the class of 2025. We wanted you to be a part of this community for a reason. Your classmates are excited to meet you, learn from you, and befriend you. Share your talent and your experiences with one another along the way. These three understandings will only occur if you make a commitment to be part of an inclusive community, one that embraces our differences and rejects racism and injustice in all forms, and to commit to living out Bentley's core values each and every day. To show you how amazing this group is, I want to share with you a video that celebrates you, the class of 2025. Thank you, and again, welcome to Bentley.
There was certainly some good advice in that video. I now call Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Donna Maria Blancero, to the lectern.
Thank you. You know, each year when I have the opportunity to stand in front of a group like this, whether it's convocation or commencement. It is by far the most humbling feeling to see all of you, so it's really just wonderful to be here. As you heard, my name is Donna Maria Blanzero, and I serve as Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs. I am truly beyond delighted to welcome each of you to Bentley. The realization that the fall semester is actually here feels wonderful. Again, welcome. I imagine many of you may be curious as to what a provost is, and the easy answer to that is it's really the best job in the world. I have the pleasure of working with amazing colleagues, exceptional students, and I also have the opportunity to think about education and learning for all of our community. More formally, the provost is the chief academic officer. I partner with our faculty and other academic leaders to ensure that we deliver a high quality, rigorous, and meaningful curriculum that will prepare you for life beyond your Bentley experience. My colleagues across the campus and I have been working for the past several months to plan for the new semester, and we really are thrilled to actually see you here in person today. However, I do want to acknowledge that you are starting your college journey at a time that is rife with uncertainty and anxiety. Not only are you embarking on a new chapter in your lives, but you are doing so in the midst of a pandemic. For those of you who are feeling nervous or tentative right now, know that you are not alone. Even though you just settled into your residence halls, you are already part of our Bentley family. And this community is full of students, faculty, and staff who care about you and are here to support you. The pandemic has considerably impacted institutions of higher education across the country and across the world. For some of you, you'll actually be stepping in a classroom for the first time since March of 2020. Please know that our faculty understand how disruptive the past 2 years have been. They want and they will be helping you learn and grow, and they will work with you to assess your existing knowledge and your familiarity with core concepts. I can say with complete certainty, our faculty are truly wonderful. They care deeply about your education and about your well-being. Additionally, you will find our exceptional staff eager to work with you and assist you in numerous ways. Over the next few days at orientation, you'll learn more about the people, the offices, and the opportunities that are available to you here on campus. I encourage you to utilize those various academic resources, including your instructors' office hours, learning labs, peer tutors, and more. Bentley has all the tools in place to help you succeed, and I challenge you to take full advantage of them. Let's face it, we've all been the new person at various times in our lives. Know that you join your class as a cohort and will have their support as well. As some of you already know, Bentley has 7 core values: caring, collaboration, diversity, honesty, impact, learning, and respect. We ground our work and our studies in these values, and they serve as guideposts for our decision making. I would like to focus on one of our values in particular right now, that of diversity. Admittedly, I'll tell you that I have a bias. My research, teaching, and consulting have centered around issues of inclusion and equity for the past 25 years, and it is very much my passion. I can tell you that over the past year, many of us have more closely examined the history and realities of racism in the United States. At Bentley, we formed a racial justice task force, and that group met for several months to assess our culture and recommend ways to build a more equitable, anti-racist campus. The task force reminded our community that change cannot happen without a real and continuing commitment from all members: students, faculty, staff, and leadership. Sometimes this commitment is painful, as we're called to recognize our blind spots or ways that we have inadvertently maintained systems of bias and discrimination. Today, more than ever, we need leaders like you to fix the inequities in the world. We need you to leverage your time at Bentley to explore the ways in which we can transform our communities and organizations into anti-racist environments. Campus culture is not owned by just a few people. We must all be in this together. Personally, I'm heartened by the beautiful diversity of our community. We have diversity of talent, diversity of identity, and diversity of lived experiences. I encourage you to investigate it further. The great transformation that awaits you at Bentley begins as you expose your mind to the diversity of perspectives around you. The pandemic has certainly reminded us how precious our relationships are. I urge all of you to take full advantage of the opportunities at Bentley to forge new, meaningful connections with your peers, your instructors, and the staff on campus. Of course, all of us are learning to connect in new ways that maintain our health and safety. As a community, we are figuring out what life looks like at this stage of the pandemic. Your patience, your understanding, and your flexibility are key as we begin this year. I feel privileged to welcome you as the class of 2025, and I wish you tremendous success as we launch this fall semester. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Blancero. I now call to the lectern Barbara Paul Emil, Professor of English and the inaugural Maurice E. Goldman Distinguished Professor of Arts and Sciences, and this year's recipient of the Adamian Award for Lifetime Teaching Excellence, to deliver the faculty address.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the faculty, I wish to welcome the class of 2025 to Bentley University. We include in this warm welcome our transfer students who've chosen to join our community. This is an important stage in your life journey. This is a journey that will shape and change your life and your world forever. As the heroes in the great mythic tales prepared for their great adventures, so now do you. As they gathered their strength, focused their resolve, so now do all of you. You are on your heroic journey. Your heroic journey, and you are starting your great adventure. One can feel the excitement, the vibrancy, and the electricity in the air. Like Odysseus in the Odyssey, like Sita in the Ramayana, and Gilgamesh in the Mesopotamian mythic tales, you are the hero of this journey, for you have answered the call. What is the call? The call is the realization that there are goals to be set, treasures to be sought, challenges to overcome, triumphs to achieve, and victories to be won. You have prepared yourself well, and now you are on the threshold of this great adventure, this great quest. You have answered the call, and you have indicated your readiness to begin the journey. And as Hamlet said in Shakespeare's great drama of the same name, readiness is all. Readiness indicates that you have made your choice. Backed by commitment and dedication, determination, the quest is on. The quest involves ambition, grit, and determination. It involves a willingness to learn, to grow, to become, to meet challenges, and to develop as a person. I recall a conversation that I had before I left for the university. I had this conversation with my favorite aunt in Montego Bay, Jamaica. And she said to me regretfully, "I was not fortunate enough to get what some might call a good education. But I have noticed," she said, "this about a good education. It is a precious possession, for it cannot be taken away. It cannot be lost or stolen, and it cannot be mislaid. It will always be yours, and the only way to lose it is to lose your mind. And if you lose your mind, you don't need it anyway." Henry Ford himself said, "The only real security that a person can have in the world is a reserve of knowledge, experience, and ability." So, education is a priceless treasure worth questing for, worth questing for. Bentley's faculty will be with you every step of the way on this journey. We are here as your teachers and guides, counselors and mentors. We are here to show the way, share our knowledge, and encourage you to be the best that you can be. Sometimes you may find our expectations to be your greatest trials, your greatest challenge. But good will come of these interactions, for they increase your knowledge, enlarge your perspectives, and move you forward to the next tier of achievement. We want your Bentley experience to be expansive, enriching, and life-changing in your study of business and the arts and sciences. We want you to bring your best to the table. We want you to bring your resilience that the provost spoke about, your ability to bounce back, to understand, and to find ways. We want your courage, your inner strength, and your willingness to see possibilities while keeping your eyes on the prize. You are all fortunate to be here in this moment and on this day. I know that many the world over would love to be in your place. In fact, I say to my classes, that line would run from here to Boston of those who would love to change places with you. We salute and thank your parents, family members, and friends who believed in you, supported you, helped you to create these possibilities for yourself. Now, let us hear a round of applause from you for your support group. Thank you, because showing appreciation is also very important on this journey. I published a poem on Carl Jung's archetypes. Archetypes are a collection of forms or primordial images that Carl Jung believed exist universally in the human unconscious. From these forms, all cultures draw literary characters, and life models, such as the concept of the hero, the warrior, the magician, the lover, the sage. These images, these forms, are to be found around the world in all cultures. So I wrote a poem about this form, and I dedicated it to my students in my course, Images of the Hero. And I read it to each new class every time I offer that course. Now, it is fitting that I share it with you and dedicate it to you on this memorable day. The poem is entitled The Hero's Path, and each of you, you are hero in your own right. You write your story, you make your choices. This path is yours. Be the hero of your life. Follow your path to the mountaintop. Be the hero of your life. Face the dragons in the depths. Commit to goals that stir the heart, to journeys that bid you start, fearlessly gaining ground each day. Know when to be the warrior. Know when to be the sage. Know when to be the ruler. Know when to be an aide. Access the lover without fear, taking steps even when courage falls away. Follow the hero's path. Know when to move forward and know when to move back. Know when to go for changes, accepting things you cannot change. Know when to trust yourself. Know when to listen to others. Know how to live with uncertainty, accepting the unknown. Be the magician, the caregiver, the trickster, the wise fool. Draw forth the thread from the labyrinthine pool of time and be the hero of your life. We welcome you as you start your journey. We welcome you to Bentley University. Thank you.
Thank you for those moving remarks and fitting poem, Barbara. I would now like to invite Bethany Barber from the class of 2023, who is majoring in information design and corporate communications and minoring in computer information systems, to the stage for today's musical performance. For this ceremony, Bethany will be performing The Climb by Miley Cyrus.
Inside my head saying you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another. Always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking. gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong.
Thank you, and welcome to Bentley University.
Thank you for that wonderful performance. Now I would like to invite Tiana Rossi from the Class of 22 and President of the Student Government Association to the lectern to offer the welcome on behalf of the student body.
Hello, everyone. Also, I'm sorry if my voice is a bit raspy. You probably saw me this morning screaming outside of Miller, so just want to apologize. Also, I'm going to do a quick O-team thing with you because I'm an orientation leader if you didn't get the gist, but can you clap once? Clap two times? Clap three times? Bethany, you killed it. That was for you. All right, sorry. Good afternoon, class of 2025. My name's Tiana Rossi, and as Iris just said, I'm the president of Bentley Student Government Association. Before I share a bit about what makes Bentley special to me, I want to start with an admission. I actually almost transferred from Bentley my freshman year here. Yes, orientation leader, you know, student government president, a self-proclaimed extreme Bentley enthusiast, was a few paper signings away from completely leaving here and starting my life over somewhere else. I came into college, like many of you, thinking I had everything figured out. I thought that I wasn't gonna be homesick, I was determined to get great grades in school, and I assumed that I'd absolutely kill it in college. But lo and behold, a few weeks before winter break, I thought I absolutely hated college, and I thought Bentley was absolutely not the school for me, and I wanted to go anywhere but here. I made no effort to get involved in organizations outside the classroom, and I assumed that the people at Bentley, they just weren't like me, and they weren't on the same page as me. I blamed everyone else but myself for the fact that I didn't like my first semester of college. To add on to that, I got back my second GB-112 exam. Side note, you all have to take this, but it's totally fine. You're gonna have a lot of support, so you're gonna be totally fine. But I had a complete quarter-life crisis over the fact that I was a student at a business school that apparently had no idea how on earth taxes worked or what the stock market was. So after my over-exaggerated disappointment over an accounting exam, I applied to a few other schools to transfer, told the few friends that I had made here that I was planning on transferring, and I got ready to completely restart my college career. I called my mom, of course, thinking that I was 100% confident in my decision, but somehow, she convinced me to stay until the second semester, And if I still didn't like it after my full first year, I could go wherever I wanted and she would be happy with my decision. I came into my second semester ready to just cruise through and continue on with my decision to leave at the end of the semester. See, this is where my college story turns into one of those like cliche happy endings, because as you can see, I didn't leave, so that's exciting. Instead, I found myself beginning to get more involved with so many of the organizations and clubs that you'll hear about over the course of the next year. By opening up and trying new things one opportunity at a time, I began to see things so differently on campus, and I fully pushed my comfort zones. I joined a sorority on campus, got more involved in the Women's Leadership Program, joined the Bentley Wall Street Group, and applied to be what wanted to become one of my favorite roles on campus, an orientation leader. In each of these clubs, I met amazing people. I knew that I had done a complete 180 and that I was planning on staying one single Sunday in April. My friends and I slept in, and we were discussing how much we loved when it rained on Sunday, because it was a good excuse for us to be lazy in the morning and get breakfast at 1 p.m. So we walked in our pajamas to the dining hall to get food, and I passed five or six people on the way that said hello to me. Then, when we got to the dining hall and got our food situation, I realized that I knew so many of the people sitting down next to me, and I truly appreciated how amazing a place and culture Bentley is. It is truly a community and a place I'm so happy to call my home. My parents, my dad, my grandpa, and my nana, and my sister, who are currently here today, will remember that after my freshman year, when I went to my hometown to see them, I started referring to Bentley as my home. Before leaving, I would say things like, "I can't wait to go back home," and I was referring to Bentley. Also, while we're on the topic of parents, like Barbara said, please make sure to thank any of the mentors, parents, guardians that got you here today, because I'm telling you, they had a hand in giving you in what will be the best 4 years of your life, which is pretty awesome. I know I may be older than you and almost ready to walk across the stage at graduation, but I promise that what I say holds true. 4 years ago, I was in the exact same seat as you, next to my roommate, who was actually convinced that I ran an Instagram meme account because my profile picture was Stewie from Family Guy. I don't run an Instagram meme account. But you have 4 short years here, and how you utilize that time is completely up to you. You have the opportunity to determine how your next 4 years will play out, and that is an amazing and somewhat frightening feeling. However, this place is the best place to take control, make mistakes, and own your decisions. This is the time to explore and enrich your life, and believe me, someone who's prepared to leave this community, when I say that Bentley offers you the opportunities to do so. It took a long time for me to figure out who I was and what I wanted to do. And although I have, you know, a small clue to no clue of what I want to do when I graduate, I'm confident and comfortable in who I've become thanks to my experience at Bentley. The people around me and the people around you at this very moment will truly enable you to be in the best position of your life. Make sure that you stay open to meeting new people by getting involved in any way you can, because the people you meet this year will be in your life for years to come, and that is something that is so special about the college experience that you're never gonna get anywhere else. By the time you're ready to start your next chapter in 4 years, you'll be ready to succeed in whichever career you choose to pursue. But as Bethany just so beautifully sang in the wise words of Miley Cyrus, it ain't about how fast you get there, and it ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's truly the climb. So I know you and the person currently sitting next to you may be really shy and unsure of what comes next, but my best friends are the ones that I made during orientation and my first weeks at Bentley. So don't be afraid to speak up for yourself and for the people around you and make every second of your time here count. Because soon enough, you'll be a senior and wondering how the time went by so quickly. College is a fantastic point in your life, and Bentley has given me something I'll never be able to experience again, and for that I'm forever grateful. Took me a little while, but investing in my Bentley experience was the best decision I have ever made. And to everyone who has made that possible, including the people sitting in the front row, I can't say thank you enough. Class of 2025, remember to get involved in every way you can on campus, and along the way, You'll learn so much and make lifelong friends. Best of luck on your journeys, and remember to be present in everything you do, and welcome to Bentley.
Thank you, Tiana. It is now my pleasure as the ceremonial marshal to welcome to the lectern the 9th president of Bentley University, Dr. E. LeBrent Kreit, who will deliver his first convocation speech at Bentley University.
Thank you very much. And before I begin, just a brief and random encounter with a couple of amazing Bentley students. Please join me again in acknowledging their talent and work ethic and ability. Bethany and Tiana, thank you. Well done. It is a delight to be here. Let me, on behalf of the faculty, trustees, and staff of this university, welcome the class of 2025 to Bentley University community and to the 2021 convocation. I also want to, as those before me have, acknowledge the sacrifice and support of your family members, parents, and others, because we appreciate that none of you got here on your own. You know, the Latin roots of convocation mean to call us together. And it is difficult for me to imagine a time in our nation's recent history in which we are not more urgently called to come together as committed, engaged, compassionate members of a shared human community. You all have the distinction of matriculating from high school and into college and into the next phase of your life's journey during an unprecedented black swan event, arguably the most cataclysmic time in our lifetimes. 19 months into a global pandemic with the accompanying social, political, and economic upheaval has resulted in a period of profound uncertainty. Your presence here today, however, reflects an enviable opportunity for renewal, reflection, and for rigorous preparation in anticipation of the myriad of opportunities and challenges that await you in life. I know that COVID tested you, but it also revealed much in you. It revealed your capacity to successfully pivot and adapt to new distributed learning platforms and to unprecedented and restrictive new norms of social interaction. It revealed your tenacity and strength in pursuit of your goals that, among other things, landed you here as a member of the Bentley University class of 2025. And your first year at Bentley, because of COVID, will be slightly altered, and we would need you to do your part to be a responsible member of this community. But you're up to this challenge as well. You all are not only well positioned to survive during these disrupted times, but you're equally capable of harnessing the resulting uncertainty and thriving in it, and leveraging this agility and stamina as a distinct competitive advantage. And as such, we expect great things from you. As has been alluded to, this convocation holds special meaning for me because, like you, I'm embarking on my first year at Bentley. I'm excited at the opportunity to share this experience with each of you. So let's please commit to supporting one another during our inaugural year here. I'd like to share, if I may, some reasons that I was so attracted to this extraordinary university. My commitment to education is manifest and deeply held. I came of age in Detroit, along with my three siblings, in the 1970s. And while I would not trade that upbringing for anything, it was not an easy place for me to succeed in or emerge from. My education launched me on a journey that has exceeded my wildest expectations. Bentley University, with its world-class faculty and exceptional staff, is powerfully committed to ensuring that each of you possess the skills and the fluencies, the integrity and the experience necessary to become value creators in a 21st century economy. But that's not all of it. Our aim is nothing less than to position you to fulfill your highest and best aspirations. And it is a profound privilege to steward such an institution. I was also drawn to Bentley because it's an institution that operates at the intersection of intellectual rigor and market relevance. We are, of course, uniquely focused on business and the liberal arts, and the education at Bentley develops and strengthens both quantitative and adaptive capacities that the marketplace demands and that society needs. I was drawn to Bentley because I believe in the power of the private sector, the power of capitalism. I've spent much of the last three decades of my life in some of the most opaque and distorted economic markets on the planet, seeking to engage communities and enterprises in the creativity and dynamism of market-based capitalism, which has been a primary catalyst for millions of people around the world to migrate out of profound and structural poverty. And though capitalism has been an undeniable factor in the creation of wealth and opportunities across the globe, its calculus and efficacy seem more complicated and uncertain in today's pandemic-laden environment. The disparities across our society are self-evident. Your education here will extend beyond what I refer to as the neoclassical economic paradigm that is often defined by a somewhat mechanistic and slightly more narrow view of capitalism's functions and toward one that recognizes and seeks to harness its openness, its nonlinearity, and its complexity. And it is in this context that we recognize, and many of your experiences at Bentley will affirm, that the power of economic capitalism, the power of the marketplace, lies not in its allocative efficiency, but in its effectiveness in promoting creativity and ultimately in impacting the human condition. The liberal arts at Bentley will result in the cultivation of rational thought to include, among other things, the preservation of the past, the pursuit of knowledge that contextualizes the present and that which illuminates the future. Tomorrow's economy, likely to exist largely at the intersection of physical and digital technologies, requires a blended skill set. Bentley is unparalleled in offering this. Here, you'll develop technical fluencies and skills while simultaneously strengthening your capacity to think critically, to discern, to effectively communicate, to engage, and to lead. And you will be the most sought-after professionals on the market. Finally, I was attracted to Bentley because of its motto. Be a force. As my colleagues have heard me communicate, we have no interest at the university of developing the mind at the expense of the heart. Now, don't get me wrong. The priority of business, of course, is profitability and success. Without that, nothing else matters. And you will be exceptionally and rigorously well prepared to contribute to the success and competitiveness of any enterprise. At its best, capitalism is about creating solutions to human problems and bringing those solutions to scale. The development of highly effective vaccines in the fight against COVID-19, in record time, no less, is a great example of the power of capitalism. The world's most pressing economic and non-economic problems are ultimately, in my view, market-based. And you will be needed to bring clarity, energy, commitment, vision, and integrity to the myriad of issues this nation and this world are facing. So that is some of what you can expect from your educational journey at Bentley University. Here are a couple of things not to expect. Do not expect to be shielded from ideas or from points of view with which you disagree. You will be armed with the fluency to refute those ideas, but you cannot hide from them here. Do not expect to be shielded from communities with which you may be uncomfortable. At Bentley, as has been said, we welcome, celebrate, and affirm a broad and inclusive community. And let me remind you, as I do often, that it is the private sector in this country and around the world that continues to lead with a clear and persistent commitment to inclusivity and diversity. Finally, do not expect not to fail. A life without failure is a life not fully lived, and we want and expect you to fail and to pick yourself up, try, iterate, do, and fail again. This is how we grow, and failure is a part of life, and you need to get used to it. As you begin your journey here at Bentley University, as you define and pursue your life's passion and purpose, I encourage you to appreciate the transformational possibilities that result from sustained exposure to differing points of view. As William Allen, the chancellor, former chancellor of the Delaware Court of Chancery, some years ago stated, and I quote, "One of the hallmarks of a truly dominant intellectual paradigm is difficulty that people have in even imagining an alternative point of view." So I hope that as you transition into this amazing community, that you will at least on occasion imagine such an alternative worldview, and more importantly, your role in creating it, and that you will accept the premise that doing good and doing well are quite intuitively aligned. Welcome to Bentley University. We are so happy to have you here, and we are richer as a result. I look forward to getting to know all of you over the coming months and years. Stay safe, take care of yourselves and one another, and enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you, President Kreit. All first-year students, please stand if able.
Today, as a class, you sit with members of your faculty. During your time at Bentley, you will work closely with individual faculty members and get to know them as teachers, mentors, and we hope and expect friends. However, the next time you are seated in front of the full faculty will be at your graduation, which for many of you will be in May 2025. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, and students of Bentley University, I welcome you to our community with all the associated rights, privileges, and responsibilities. Members of the academic procession and platform party, please stand and join me in welcoming the class of 2025.
Please be seated. Convocation 2021 has concluded. In keeping with tradition, all faculty and new students will leave the convocation ceremony together, symbolizing the start of their academic journey. Students, please remain seated until your row is called, and please keep the center aisle clear until the last student has exited. I ask that all guests remain seated until the last student has exited this convocation ceremony. Thank you for joining us. You are all now part of the Bentley family.
Thank you.